Am uite secultul de ies. Poate în termodinamic limite te secultul zero. But in general, mu is less than equal to zero than for bosons. So mu is always bigger than zero for fermions, and mu cannot be positive for bosons. So sometimes it's equal to zero, like here, but it's only zero temperature. And as you increase temperature, the chemical potential will go down. So if you look at chemical potential as a function of temperature, you will see that chemical potential is equal to zero for certain ranges of temperature. Again, in that sense. But we have like 1 over n, so it's equal to zero. And then after this, it becomes negative. Chemical potential as a function of temperature behaves like this. So if I look at chemical potential, I did not prove this yet, but if I look at chemical potential at zero temperature, it's equal to zero. Then as I increase temperature, it will stay zero for a while, and then eventually it becomes negative. It's not obvious, I'm going to show it, but it's not obvious. So what you see, but even from already from this graph, if you believe me, you would say that from this graph, you would conclude that there is a phase transition going on. Because if I look at the derivative, it's discontinuous. Right? So derivative here was zero, and derivative here is not zero, so there's a jump. And this is a phase transition, so it's phase transition out of condensation. So transition from condensate to no condensate. Here you have Bose-Einstein condensate, here you have no condensate. And there is a transition between these two points, which is a phase transition. We are going to talk about it for in a moment. Okay, is this clear? So far, okay, what did we discuss so far? We discussed only the system at zero temperature. At zero temperature, we found that formally chemical potential is negative but tiny, but in thermodynamic limit, it means it's equal to zero, because it scales like 1. So now let's talk about finding the value of chemical potential at non-zero temperature. So suppose T is not equal to zero. At t equals to zero, we found the value, and at t equals to zero, the value is zero. Now let's talk about non-zero value of temperature. How do you find chemical potential? You use something like this. You lose normalization, but you have to be careful, because this normalization does not include ground state. Ground state is very singular. So what you have to do is you have to pull the ground state by n. So you write that n is equal to L0, which is this, plus sum over k, which is not equal to zero, this sum for all other k's except for the ground state. So this gives you equation for mu at non-zero temperature.
And the answer will always be negative, right?
The answer will always be negative, yes. Huh? Ah, very good. Yeah, so very good. So it depends. So, nice. Very good. Somebody's reading my notes. No. Very good. This is a very good point. So then there are two options. One is temperature is bigger, less than Tc. So this is a critical temperature.
Where it starts to break.
Where it starts to deviate. So below this temperature, this mu is equal to zero. We know that by the graph.
Well, it's never entirely equal to zero unless you're...
No, that you're not supposed to.
Okay.
So, if you're below critical temperature, your mu is equal to zero. Then, this is equation for Nc. For n. So, if you take mu equals to zero, you can compute this sum, and you find something. We did it in the case where beta was equal to infinity. We did it in the case of zero temperature. So what we did is precisely this exercise, but at this point. But now you can do this exercise for all other values of temperature, which is above zero, but below Tc. Then you know that your chemical potential is equal to zero by continuity. So your chemical potential is equal to zero, and you get equation for n0. And this is what you did when you were doing your homework assignment. And if temperature is bigger than T critical, Then you will find that L naught is equal to zero. And then you'll get the equation for mu. Again, what's going on? So what does it mean that chemical potential is equal to zero? It means that it costs you nothing to add particle to the system. What was the chemical potential? It's change in energy when you add one more particle. Right? Suppose you have condensate. If I add one more particle, it just goes directly to condensate. So I add particle and it costs me nothing. So if I have any condensate at all, then my mu must be equal to zero. So in other words, that mu equals to zero is equivalent to saying that N naught is not equal to zero. So if I have a condensate and I add one more particle that goes to condensate, chemical potential is zero. Now suppose my condensate already disappeared. Nothing can go into this state. So my mu will be negative. Again, I did not prove that it would be negative. But so if I have T is then less than Tc, then mu is equal to zero. I get the equation for N naught. And N naught will be somewhere between zero and capital N. So if I draw the corresponding picture, this is my mu. It's equal to zero, and then it keeps changing, starts changing. If I draw my N naught as a function of temperature, it will start from N, and it will go down. And after this temperature, it will be equal to zero. Exactly. That's exactly like Mann. Because all phase transitions of the second order are the same. It's just the question which variable would work. They all look very similar. This should remind you of the curve for magnetization. When we did the phase transition for ferromagnet, that's curve it looks exactly the same. Now you have number of particles in the condensate, but it's exactly the same. So and the transition point is, of course, the same. Once your chemical potential becomes negative, your N0 becomes 0. And when your chemical potential is equal to 0, N0 is positive. Okay? Questions?
Didn't they refer to it in the book as one of them being N occupied? They referred to one of the ends as number of particles in an occupied state. Or am I mistaken?
N zero. So at precisely zero temperature, only this ground state is going to be occupied. If you have some slightly higher temperature, most particles will be here, but some particles will go up.
Okay.
And the higher your temperature, the more particles are going to go up, and eventually this state is going to be empty.
Okay.
Question. Huh? Decondensation, yes. Condensate disappears. Right, so this is this Tc.